Angie. Hey, we're gonna learn it from Angie. She's a robot from Sweet. We're gonna learn it from Angie.
That's me. Welcome to Engineering Expo. Well, what are you waiting for? Let's go.
I'm Jess. I'm an engineering project manager with On Point, a Koch Industries company. I'm also a member of the Engineering Expo Committee. Here with me today, other Jess.
Hey there. I'm a licensed engineer with Professional Engineering Consultants. I am also a member of the Engineering Expo Planning Committee.
Today, we're going to be talking about tensile bubbles. Here's a list of the materials that you'll need.
So what's a tensile bubble?
That's a really good question. So tensile bubble is really just a way for us to get to play with bubbles and soap today. But also, it's going to teach us about the properties of surface tension.
Oh, like that leaky faucet in your house?
Yes, that is a very good example of surface tension. So if I think about it as I watch it and I see how the leak starts to form, you just see this drip of water. And it's like it grows and grows and grows on the faucet. Like water stretching. But when you think about water, it doesn't seem like water would stretch. But what's really cool about that is because of surface tension, it does. And then all of a sudden, it drips. And it's kind of annoying. So another example, have you ever been to the park or somewhere where there's water and you've seen all the little bugs that just run across the surface of the water?
Oh, they're like skipping and jumping on the water.
Yeah. So that's another reason of surface tension and how the bugs are able to run across water without actually falling down into it.
Oh, that is really cool. So how does it relate to these things?
So that's a great question. So it's not like we've got a bunch of bugs on water here around us, but I want you to be able to learn about surface tension. So we're going to take these and we're going to be able to make these. And then if we dip them in a soapy water, we can actually physically see how surface tension works based off of the shapes.
Oh, that is really awesome. So let's get started.
All right. So now we're going to make our own tetrahedrons.
Don't be weird, Jess. It's a pyramid.
Okay, so now we're going to make our own pyramids, but we're still going to learn about surface tension. So in the description below, we have the steps that we're following, but we have them here with us just to make it a little bit easier. So with that, what you're going to need to do is you're going to take your straws and you want to cut them into four sections, but the important part is that they're the same size. The best part to do this, or the best way to get started, is to start in the middle of your straws and then go from there.
As you can see, mine aren't perfectly even. If they're a little off, it's not gonna ruin your pyramid.
Okay, so now when you have these, as you can see, the pyramid is really just a bunch of triangles all put together. So we're gonna start by putting three pieces onto a pipe cleaner. So you take your pieces and you feed them in. So what's important here before we make the triangle is we actually want to bend one of the little end pieces over so that your straws aren't going to come off of it. Okay. So now that you have that, you're going to form it into the triangle shape, and you're actually going to connect your pipe cleaners so that it doesn't move. Okay. So now that you have that base triangle that's made, you're going to want to put two more pieces of your straws on there. Now, this is where your pipe cleaner might seem a little bit short if you try and do that, and that's okay because we can take another pipe cleaner and we're going to add it to it. You just want to be really careful in how you twist these together so that it doesn't get stuck on it. Yeah. So as you can see, it's almost as if mine was trying to get stuck. So just be careful as you feed it through there. Okay, so now the question that you have is, okay, great, but it needs to be a 3D shape. So this is where you're actually going to take it and you're going to feed the pipe cleaner back through the edge of your triangle that you had already made. So again, you're gonna see, and if you pull it too tight and you didn't have it twisted good enough, it'll come undone. So if that happens, just re-twist it. Make sure it's tight. And then feed it back through. Okay, so now that you have two sides of your pyramid, tetrahedrons, all you have left to do now is put the final piece in to make that third side. Okay, so now you have two triangles and one little piece, but to make it to where it makes it the 3D shape, you're just gonna feed it your pipe cleaner underneath and wrap it around so that it makes it your very own tetrahedron.
The real pyramid.
Yes, okay, fine. You have your very own pyramid. What's great about it is you have a longer edge, so now we have a handle. So when we want to play with the bubbles, we don't necessarily have to get our hands really messy.
And if you're a little clumsy like me, you might want to put a little loop on there so that you can wrap it on your finger.
Okay, so we now have our pyramids, and we're going to see how does surface tension work. So this is where you're going to have wanted to make your solution. And what I'm going to say, we made a lot of solution today because we wanted to make sure that everybody could see it. If you're doing this at home, there's a lot of soap that goes into this. So you probably are going to want to use a smaller container than what we have here. To make this soap, it's going to be 6 parts water, 1 part soap, and then it's going to be
1/4 cup of Karo corn syrup.
So with that, again, those instructions might be a little difficult. You can find them in the description below.
It says, you can see we've already made this and we skimmed off some of the bubbles because if the bubbles are in place, that will interfere with the surface tension. So you want to try to avoid the bubbles when you're dipping it in.
Okay, so let's do surface tension.
All right.
Okay, so as I said, got our pyramids. We're going to do it and we're just going to dip it in.
You don't need to swish it around, just dip.
You pull it out. And can you see? You can actually see the bubbles have formed different angles. And it's like you have your own lines in there.
Is that not cool?
So we just did surface tension. No bugs involved.
Which I am a fan of.
So we were able to have a little bit of fun and a little bit of a mess as we were playing with our bubbles and getting to do surface tension. So the cool part about it is you can see we used our tetrahedron.
Pyramids.
We used our pyramid and we got to see how surface tension works when it's three sides. You also saw where Jess used the cube and was able to see what it would do if there was 4 or more sides.
And if you would like to make your very own cube to dip in the solution, go ahead and follow the instructions below.
So with that, I'd love for you to take out your engineering notebooks, and I have a couple questions for you. If you were doing this at home, maybe write down some of the other shapes that you would want to make and show what those would look like, and write that down in your notebook. Because you saw when we used the pyramid and when we used the cube, how that formed the surface tension. Go ahead and write your hypothesis for what you think other shapes would show.
Thank you for joining us today and learn a little bit about surface tension and playing with some bubbles. I hope you had as much fun as we did.
Especially learning about tetrahedrons.
Pyramids.
So with that, as I just said in your engineering notebook, I wanted you to write down some different shapes that you think you could make that would be able to show the different surface tensions when you dip it in the solution. So with that, get some pictures or maybe even a short little video of you doing this experiment, whether it be with the pyramid or with the cubes or any of the shapes. And then I want you to go ahead and post that on our event page.
Ooh, you can win a prize.
Yeah, you can get a prize. Who doesn't love prizes? So until then,
see you next time. Ooh.
many of my bubbles. She's a
robot from like dinosaur noses?
Kind of.
Yeah.
So I learned.
That's me. Thanks for joining us today. See you next time.